What's good, everybody? Hey, welcome back to my channel, Smoking and Grilling and Cooking with me, AB. Now, check this out, you guys. You guys read the title. You know I'm making a creamy mac and cheese, right? So listen, I want to tell you, here's my dilemma. I was trying to figure out how do I simplify, or you know what I mean, just how do I present it when this is just like a true classic, not a whole lot of ingredients, and it's easy already. But I do have a couple of little things that I do that, when, you know, that I put on there. And for one, I'm gonna start off by just showing you guys this, just that Creole kick. This is what I'm gonna season my, I'm gonna season my creamy cheese sauce with that, you know? And I'm gonna tell you what makes this so good. It's not just the fact that, you know, it tastes great, you know what I mean? It's got the perfect blend, to, you know, to make it that Creole slash Cajun, you know, seasoning, but it doesn't have a lot of sodium in it. You know what I mean? So listen, it still allows you to wake up your dish with using a little, you know, salt. So I'm gonna use salt. Look, right here, this is just nothing but two heaping tablespoons of flour. I got 2 tablespoons of butter, but I'm gonna tell you one thing. Some of you guys that don't wanna use like, you know, bacon fat, you guys use that butter. But for me, where is it at right here? I'm gonna go ahead and use this right here. Y'all know this, and bacon fat. Keep this with all of my, after all of my bacon cooks. So got that. Listen, we're gonna shred some cheese. Got Monterey sharp cheddar. Listen, it's the holidays, folks. Don't use no, I mean, if you have to, you have to. You know what I mean? If you press for time or whatever, you know what? I'm gonna just say, go ahead and use that pre-shredded cheese, but be careful. You know, it's got that waxy film on it. You know, a little bit harder to melt. But I like fresh. This right here is gonna mix. You guys are gonna be amazed about that. And check it out. I'm gonna make it look like this is like an infomercial right here. This right here is my go-to when I do the shredding. This is made by KitchenAid. Listen, ain't no sponsor video or nothing like that. I'm just, you know, amazed at the fact that when you shred, it goes right here in the bottom of the Tupperware and it has a top. So listen, there's no reason why you don't have fresh, you know, shredded cheese, you know, all the time. So got that. We're gonna use some milk. You know what I mean? A cup of milk. And then I got regular elbow, you know, noodles. That's it. Got a big giant box. Not gonna make that much. This video is really just to show you guys what I do, and I'm gonna be making it in this. So look, now you know. Oh, one key thing. When we make our noodles, we gonna cook it just like it says on the instructions, but we gonna stop right away. I'm gonna go ahead and pour it in my colander, and I'm gonna shock it with that cold water because I don't want it to cook no more. Why? Because we going into the oven at 350 degrees, you know what I mean? And we gonna bake it, and it's gonna continue to cook in there. So, super simple, nothing to it, so let's make it happen. All right, first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna start shredding some of my cheese. So, I'm gonna start with just a Monterey. It doesn't make no difference what you start with. Just gonna peel it back. Now, these are both 1 pound, you know, each. So I would just say this, you know what, as you'll see in this video, I did put 2 pounds of cheese on the top because I like that crust, you know what I mean? And I wanted it to be super creamy, you know, underneath. Okay, I got my noodles on. I'm boiling my water right now. That's what I'm doing. So we're going to multitask. So now I'm going to go ahead and just hit medium high heat. Now, once your pot has heated up, go ahead and introduce, you know, your bacon fat. Bacon grease, rendered bacon, or whatever you guys want to call it. And those of you guys that don't want to use no bacon fat, go ahead and just use, you know, 2 tablespoons of butter. And now what you're seeing me do is add in the flour. And notice that I'm putting the flour in just a little bit at a time. You want to cook that raw flour taste out of there. So once that's done, I say that'll probably take you about anywhere between like a minute and a half to 2 minutes. And then what you want to do is you want to start introducing your milk. So that was 1 cup of milk. And listen, the key is it's in your elbow, your wrist, and that whisk. That's where you're gonna make your roux at right there. And then what you saw me doing right now is just take a handful of cheese and just start putting it in there. Now, I think my heat was a little high. You wanna have like a medium low heat. You know what I mean? It's gonna take a little while, but you want it to melt. And you, right there, you can see I'm just checking my consistency and I'm liking what I'm seeing. Now, once I got about 3/4 of my 3/4 of my cheese in there, you know, that was that sharp cheddar, then I went ahead and put a handful of that Monterey cheese. You know, I do like a little mix. Okay, now once that's done, you got the consistency you like. Okay, what I do is, listen, I take some butter and I grease my pan. Hey, super easy. Hey, and that's key right there. You don't want nothing to stick. Or you can use, you know, some kind of baking spray, you know, non-stick spray. Now that we're done with our noodles, you can see they still, you know, nice and hot. I just shocked them for a hot second and I didn't continue to rinse them. Go ahead, put those in your pan, stir up your cheese, and then look, there you go right here. Now, I just want to tell you this. Listen, I usually make a lot more, so I really divided it into half. I just suggest that you guys make your cheese sauce and look at these ingredients and just double everything. That way you'll have a lot of cheese sauce. And this was actually going out to somebody. When they see this video, they're gonna say, hey, you made a video off of the mac and cheese that you made for me, you know, for me. So this was actually an order. They just wanted a small order, so that's why, you know, it's so small. Now, once you got it all, you know, mixed up, go ahead and take your remaining cheese. Now this is where you decorate the top. This part is really totally up to you. You can do it any kind of way you would like. I like to have, you know, the two cheeses on top. You know what I mean? I like the combination, the blend that it gives you. Hey, and with that Creole kick and that cheesy sauce, man, I can tell you it's just amazing. Now, go ahead and just cover it, and we're going to go in the oven for 30 minutes covered. That's key. Once we get it into the oven, and after 30 minutes, I'm going to show you what it looks like. So boom, with the magic of editing, this is what we come up with. And this is how it's gonna look right here. Let me hurry up and get this top off. There you go. Now, we're not done. Now I had a little extra cheese. I'll go ahead and put some on top because I want that to brown a little bit myself. So then we're gonna go back into the oven for about another 20 minutes, you know, uncovered. Listen, the key is you gotta look at it and then stay on top of it because you don't wanna burn that cheese. And keep in mind that when you pull it out of the oven, that cheese gonna continue to brown for about a minute. So tell me what you guys think about this one here. You know what, super easy. You know what, everybody has their own style of making it, but this right here with this Creole kick, this right here sends it over the top. I gotta let you know that, you know, I don't get nothing for that. This is just like a great tasting seasoning, and just the fact that it doesn't have all of that sodium in it, this is it right here. So let me know down in the comment section below, you know, what you guys wanna see, because I got on my horizon right now, check this out. I'm getting ready to do a seafood mac and cheese. Let's get past these holidays and we finna make that happen. Now, if you're new to my channel, let me just take this time to say, hey, thank you for watching. You know what? Don't forget to like this video and subscribe. Most importantly, you gotta subscribe. Hey, and let everybody know out here, there's a channel out here that's simplifying these recipes and taking the mystery out of cooking. Hey, so with that being said, if you've been watching me and you've been with me for a minute, you know how I'm finna get out of here. Peace.